Hello and welcome to the demonstration video of QuickIT brought to you by Spread Eagle Apps and Solutions. QuickIT has been designed as an add-in for Microsoft Excel aimed to assist child accountants and other income tax professionals in their advisory and compliance functions. Okay, so here in front of me we have a typical statement of income. On the top we have the header section, which has the SSE details. These have been formatted as Excel validation dropdowns. Altering any values here would result in changing the values in these cells over here. Now these are true and false values. The reason for doing this will get apparent shortly. Okay, QuickIT provides computational functionality for 6 assessment years. Updated right up to assessment year 14-15, and 15-16 also will be added shortly after the bill becomes an act. So this is the statement of income of the SSE. Now thing to note here is that the SSE has agriculture income. Now think about agriculture income is that we need to use the partial integration method. So if you do not have QuickIT, then you would have to use a table based approach like this. You'd have to write the total income, add the agriculture income, the aggregate income, then use a table based approach and find out the tax on that. Take the agriculture income, add to the basic exemption limit, and use again a table based approach like this to calculate the tax. And it gets very tedious and cumbersome and error prone as well, and not versatile. So you cannot change the various criteria and have this altered automatically. But now QuickIT provides a function just like any other worksheet function. You just have to type equals to itax, INDVAG, put in the relevant arguments. So I'll just pop up the arguments dialog box here. The shortcut for doing that is Shift F3. So take 6 arguments: total income, agricultural income, assessment year, date of birth. Now thing to note here is you have to only enter the date of birth and not the age. So as soon as you put the date of birth, it will calculate the age as of the relevant assessment year and then use that to determine the correct slab. Is female is a true and false value. This is the reason why we had computed those cells on top. So in our case, SSE is female, so this would be true. Is NR or NOR, as our SSE is resident, this would be false. And yes, that's it. That's all it takes. And we have the answer right here. Okay. Let's go to capital gains. Without QuickIT, for computing index cost of acquisition, you'd have to grab a reckoner or go online and get the CII, right? Now you don't have to do that. With QuickIT, you get a worksheet function is equal to index cost, put in the cost of acquisition, the date of transfer, and the date of acquisition. That's it. Now this assessee is availing has made an investment in a residential property availing exemption under section 54F. Now say she called me and she wanted the answer to the question, what is the income tax incidence due to this particular transaction. She would give me all these details, she would give me an investment made and all the relevant details, and she would ask me this question. I had to answer in a minute, less than a minute actually. So QuickIT now makes it possible. The function for doing this is LTCG tax 54F. It takes 5 arguments: consideration, date of transfer, cost of acquisition, date of acquisition, and investment amount. That's it. And simple. Within less than a second, you get the answer directly here. This is a tax incident, inclusive of education cess. Without QuickIT, you would have to necessarily make a table like this, then calculate the exemption, calculate the taxable capital gains, and then calculate the tax on that and add the education cess. Done very easily for you and error free. Okay. Now say this wasn't a gain, it was a loss. So I'll just make the consideration 0, so it would result in a loss. Yeah. It informs the assessee the computation results in a loss, so please read the relevant sections to determine whether the loss can be carried forward in the given circumstance. Just like this, QuickIT and many of its functions provides tips and guidance to the user. So So this would be very useful. Okay, now let's quickly run through all the functions that are provided by QuickIT. Okay, so this pops up the function wizard of Excel. Now here we have another category added called QuickIT. Okay, so first we have CII, cost inflation index. Just give the transaction date and you get the CII. Disallowance on the 14A. Okay, now if you have any expenditure relating to income which does not form part of total income, you have to disallow it under section 14A, right? So this function easily provides helps you doing that. This uses rule 8D to accomplish the same. So you have to enter these arguments. Now here you can see you have to give opening investment amount, closing investments, opening total assets, and etc. Right? So what you can do is, in your balance sheet, you can just give the cell references of those balance sheet items, and while in the course of finalization, whenever those change, this automatically get updated. Now without QuickIT, you would have to take care that whenever you change the balance sheet, you would have to come here and manually check that whether and update it, and check manually whether any change would take place on the disallowance amount or not. Now with QuickIT, you don't have to do any of that; it'll take care of itself. Okay, let's move along. Gold price, you enter a transaction date and it gives you the relevant gold price per 10 grams as per the RECNA. Index cost we've already seen. ITEX INTV, very similar to ITEX INTV AG. It does not factor in agricultural income, that's the only difference. But however, I would advice that you use ITEX INTV AG itself, because if you do not have agricultural income, put that argument as zero. Okay, now ITEX Corp. This is used to calculate the tax for companies. You have to give four arguments: total income, book profit, assessment year, and is foreign company or not. So as would be evident that this also factors in MAT. So it will calculate the regular income tax, calculate the MAT, and return the higher of the two. And also supports functionality for six assessment years. Now a question that might have come to your mind is that if MAT is applicable, then MAT credit would be available, correct? So we have a function to calculate the MAT credit as well. You have to enter the same four arguments and it will tell you what would be the MAT credit available as well. Okay, let's go to the next. Okay, LTCG, you have to give the four relevant arguments and it will directly tell you the long-term capital gains. LTCG tax, the same four arguments will give you the incidence of long-term capital gains tax inclusive of education cess. LTCG tax 54, just like LTCG tax 54F, but uses 54 to determine the exemption. Okay, MAT credit we've already seen. NSC interest, okay. Returns the accrued NSC interest per rupees 100, takes two arguments, the date of purchase of the NSC and the number of years completed. Opt HRA. Now, I'm sure all of you during the course of your practice must have been asked this question many a times, that how do we structure the salary, how do we structure the HRA amount so that the maximum possible benefit of the HRA exemption would be available. Yes. So QuickIT does this in a jiffy. You just have to enter the total CTC, the other allowances, that is which is not HRA, and all the other accounts apart from the two, and you have to state whether this is in a metro city or not, and that's it. And it'll tell you the amount of HRA that you have to factor so that the entire amount would get exempted. Now OPT, rent to pay. Again, a common question asked is, given a particular HRA amount, how much rent should be paid so that the entire amount of HRA would get exempted? So you have to give two arguments here. the basic plus DA amount and the HRA amount. Now I would suggest that you first use the OPT HRA, find out the optimum HRA, then use this function to find out the rent to pay. That would be the maximum possible benefit that would be available. Okay, silver price, just like the gold price, returns the silver price. Surcharge. So this surcharge for individuals takes the same six arguments as ITAX, INDV, AG. So what this essentially does is, from the assessment year, determines whether surcharge is applicable or not, determines the surcharge limit, checks for marginal relief, then calculates the tax and calculates the surcharge on the tax, factoring in marginal relief and returning you the correct answer. Okay, now last year we have surcharge CORP for companies. Takes the same four arguments like ITAX CORP or MAT credit, and it does the same thing, determines whether surcharge is applicable, factors in marginal relief, and returns the correct answer. Okay, these were the functions that were provided by this by QuickTax. Now QuickTax also provides some utilities. Now here in Excel, another tab gets added called QuickIT. You click on that tab, you get three buttons here. Now for professionals, time is the most valuable asset, right? So say I want to email this particular computation, so I just email it from here, or send any other email. I can just use this, it'll connect to my Outlook and it'll send an email from there. Add to Outlook calendar. Now take this example itself. The assessee is going to make an investment in residential property under 54F, right? This has certain time limits. Say I want to set a reminder in my Outlook for this particular for the due date. So I can do it directly from Excel itself. I just click on this button and Outlook's calendar entry screen would be activated, and I can just put in the details and save it there. Okay, income tax website. Clicking this button takes me directly to incometaxindia.gov.in. Okay, so thank you. I hope this has been informative. Our contact details and all other relevant details would flash on screen in this video. And you can get in touch with us and get your very own copy of QuickIT. Okay. Thank you again.